Goodness, we are out of that hole. Don't think your job is done. I refuse to cooperate until you provide a body that meets my standards.
Hey.
What can I do for you?
Here you go, Ada. The final radar beacon. I'll need that head back when you're done.
Of course. Shouldn't take but a moment. There you go. Still in one piece. I'm not sure why you want the head back. All we needed was its radar beacon. Besides, robo-brains are notorious for being, well, a real pain in the neck.
What else do you know about the Ada?
Quite simply, it's the first time General Atomics produced a successful union between organic matter and robotics. The brain is used both as a control unit and a data storage unit, which is far more efficient than using standard circuits. Unfortunately, there were a lot of programming issues with these robots, which caused them to be a bit, shall we say, unhinged. Hopefully, this particular robo-brain will have some of the answers that we've been seeking.
A union of organic matter and robotics? Sounds an awful lot like a synth.
Not at all. The robo-brain was built with a very different design philosophy in mind. General Atomics' intent was to use the human brain to augment the robot's functions, primarily to accelerate the decision-making process. Free thought and individuality was never intended. These were expressly built like soldiers, to follow orders without question. The robo-brain's unfortunate tendency towards violence and aggression should be considered more of a malfunction than a calculated decision.
Now that you have the final radar beacon, will it be enough to track down the mechanist's location?
I certainly hope so. I've already started the calculations while we've been having this conversation. That still doesn't explain why you need that head back.
We still need it, Ada. I believe it can help us access the mechanist's facility.
Of course. It makes perfect sense that the mechanist would not only keep its location a closely guarded secret, but would secure it against intrusion as well. I'm terribly sorry. I hadn't considered that possibility at all. I'm afraid when it comes to assisting humans, I'm not doing very well lately.
Why would you say something like that?
Isn't it obvious? Ever since I let my friends die in that caravan, I feel like I've been failing in my duties. I chose the route we took the day we were attacked. Perhaps if I'd selected an alternate route, they'd still be alive. Sometimes I wish that Jackson had programmed me with my personality mode set permanently to disabled.
Your personality mode? What do you mean?
Most robots have a personality mode select available to them for their creator to utilize. Turn it on, and we're designed to talk and act more like a human. Turn it off, and we're no better than a mindless automaton. Jackson said he didn't think of me as a servitor robot. He treated me more like a friend. So he permanently set my personality mode to on. He said I should never lose my identity. I suppose I'm starting to think he was wrong.
Your personality defines you as an individual. Never let that go.
You're right. All of the good memories I've experienced being Ada would be lost if my personality mode was shut down. I can't afford to lose them. I really think I needed to hear that from someone else. Thank you. Now I've distracted you for long enough. I'll finish up my calculations while you deal with our new friend, Jezebel. Hopefully, she'll be able to grant us access to the mechanist's facility and we can put an end to this nonsense once and for all.
Thank you. You know what? Since we talked, I'm feeling swell. Look at the two of us here in Sanctuary. Prepared for the future.
Yeah.
Carla.
Hey there. Trading?
I'll take a look, sure.
Yeah, keep your shirt on.
Yes. Ada?
Here you are, sir.
Hey.
Is there something I can help you with?
That's all for now.
All right.
Interesting. This body you've selected for me isn't quite what I had envisioned. but it will have to suffice.
What kind of body were you expecting?
Considering I look like a junk bot that's been hastily welded together by an amateur, I'd say almost anything else would have been better. However, I suppose I shouldn't be surprised, given your limited skill set derived from your equally diminished intelligence.
Sorry, Your Highness. The Royal Taylor has been quite ill, and I'm afraid the task fell to me instead.
If you're attempting to use sarcasm as an intimidation tactic, I'm afraid you're wasting your time. Look, it's obvious we don't care for each other's company, which suits me just fine. So, why don't you ask me everything you wanted to know, and then I'll be on my way.
Why did General Atomics make you so uncooperative?
I haven't the faintest idea of what you're talking about. I am a top-of-the-line model, with an efficiency rating that makes Mr. Handy look like a glorified toaster oven. When given a set of instructions, I will complete them without question and without error. Now, were there any other ridiculous questions you wanted to ask?
Tell me everything you know about the Mechanist.
Now there's a fascinating subject. The Mechanist, amazingly adept at programming, a veritable genius with electronics. I'm not surprised you're interested. I've been dutifully carrying out the Mechanist's instructions to help the people of the Commonwealth for quite a long time.
Helping the people of the Commonwealth? You?
Absolutely. It's my primary directive. The Mechanist instructed me to seek out and help the people of the Commonwealth. By my calculations, the easiest way to help a human is simply to destroy it. There's no point in prolonging a laughably fragile life. It's the most efficient way to assist them. Any other effort to help tends to result in numerous complex side effects.
The Mechanist gave you these instructions? To kill people?
Well, not exactly. The specific instruction was to help people. I merely interpreted the most efficient way to perform my duties. Assisting a human to the best of my abilities only affords a 25% survival rate. That means there's a 75% chance that despite my efforts, the human I'm assisting will die from something beyond my control. Therefore, it's better to hasten the human's death and put them out of their likely chance of misery than to deplete my limited time. It's actually quite elementary, but given your minimal intellect, I suppose I shouldn't be surprised you don't understand.
Can we stop with the petty bickering and just get to the part where you tell me how to access the Mechanist's facility?
I promised to answer your questions, and unlike humans, I don't have the capacity to lie. It's rather simple, really. In order to gain entry to the Mechanist's facility, you're going to need to outfit one of your robots with an MSAT modification. I'll upload the plans to your Pip-Boy device. There. I've fulfilled my portion of our agreement. Perhaps I'll remain here for a while and see how things resolve between yourself and the Mechanist. Purely for my own amusement, of course. I suspect you'll have quite a tale to tell once you return. But then again, I'd be surprised if you ever return at all. Haven't you already interfered enough? Go away.
Hey.
Yes, sir?
Hey, Ada.
I trust you've completed your business with Jezebel. I hope she wasn't too difficult.
Is there a chance these robots could be misinterpreting orders?
Yes, I've considered the possibility.
Hey.
I'd be happy to. I trust you've completed your business with Jezebel. I hope she wasn't too difficult.
Is there a chance these robots could be misinterpreting orders?
Yes, I've considered the possibility. The contradictory nature of the Mechanist's broadcasts are troubling. But the truth is, regardless of intent, the Mechanist needs to be stopped. These robots are too much a threat. Were you able to discover how to gain access to the Mechanist?
Think we can trust what Jezebel said? I'm hoping she doesn't have her own interpretation of the word access, too.
We'll soon find out. What did she have to say?
I need to outfit a robot with something called an MSAT. Jezebel gave me the plans.
A custom modification that acts as a key to the Mechanist facility. Very smart. In fact, chances are high the MSAT may be required for multiple access points, like a robot identification card. As for my task, I was able to decrypt the signal with the final radar beacon. The source is coming from a Robco sales and service center, most likely a front for a larger operation. It's time to take the offensive. Have you formulated a plan?
Did you have any ideas?
I am at an impasse. I wish to see the Mechanist endure the same fate as my friends, but I know this to be due to my personality subroutine. When I compartmentalize, I want to know reason and motive before passing judgment. This is why I leave the decision to you. Now, if you're ready, I believe you have an MSAT to install. It's always fascinating watching you create.
Hey.
Yes.
Heads up.
Is there something I can help you with?
Didn't have anything else.
Very well.
Heads up.
What can I do for you?
Ada?
Did you require my assistance?
We should go our separate ways.
I'd prefer to remain by your side, but I'll abide by your command.
just go away? Haven't you done enough to torment me already?
Would you like me to go with you?
Time to hit the road.
Excellent. I'll endeavor to do my best. Oh my, it's raining again. Fortunately, it won't affect my electronics.
Alive.
Yes, sir.
Wait there.
Understood. Please be careful, sir.
Look alive. Come on.
I'll take care of it. Powering down weapons, sir. Something.
Stop right there. Great stag. I am friend.
Now, now, it's okay.
found such interesting finds.
Can you see that, sir? Gwyn! Disappearing act.
Excuse me.
Didn't expect help from a stranger. Thanks.
You looking for a new place to settle?
Could be. Why? Do you know of somewhere good?
What are you looking for?
I just want to find some place safe to live without these assholes trying to kill me all the time. Why? Do you know of a good place?
I sure do.
Thanks. See you there in a day or two.